Hey, Naima back with you again. It is now almost 7 o'clock on Wednesday morning, May 8th. I've left my godparents in North Carolina. Had a really nice time with them. Ate until I was stuffed, a couple nights in a row, and got to have some good conversation, and that was great. So now I've driven about... I've driven about 3.5 hours. I am in Statham, Georgia, where my cousin Nyerere lives. Me and Nyerere have always been really, really close. We're about a year apart. However, we never lived in the same area. My father only had one sibling. He had a younger brother, which was my Uncle Donald. And Uncle Donald was a college professor. He got his doctorate when he was 27 in political science. And I believe he was at Florida State for a little while. Then when I was younger in Georgia, he was at Georgia Southern, which is in Statesboro, and then he went to Mississippi State, and that's where he finished out his career as a professor. Nyerere's kind of followed in his footsteps, got his master's degree when he was about 24. I think eventually he's going to get a doctorate, but anyway, we grew up far apart from each other, our whole lives, and my father would go down south to visit my uncle, and a lot of times my siblings wouldn't come, but I would come for the 15-hour or whatever drive it was, because I wanted to see Nyerere. We've just always been two peas in the pod. I don't think we've ever had an argument, and I don't know. I wonder what my life would have been like if we had been closer in proximity. He's kind of the other side of my coin, As my journey goes along, you'll hear more of my story about, the things that I went through, and the car accidents and the depression and dangerous circumstances and alcoholism and all that. And I don't know, Nyerere's kind of, I guess, what I feel like maybe my life would have gone had things not been so rocky when I was younger. But nevertheless, he and I are extraordinarily close. And even if it's a year or two when we don't see each other, we get together, and it's like nothing ever happened. So we're going to go out in a second. He's actually up... getting his son Nyerere Jr. ready for school, and we're going to say hi to them real quick. Just a side note, as I was leaving yesterday, I was getting all my stuff back together with my godparents, and my godmother commented to me, oh my gosh, you're so organized. And I was thinking about that when I was on the road, because, it's amazing. I am now. I am, I've been able to get my whole life into my car as I drive across the country, and I'm such a far cry from where I was 5 years ago, and that's just a testament to the grace of God. And, you'll hear me refer to plenty of things along the line about the mistakes that I made and the bad decisions and the bad situations that I was in. But that is the reason for this trip. That is the reason I'm going across the country, that I've given up my job, that I've given up pretty much everything to find, my true purpose for life, because after everything that I've been through, there's no way. It was all by accident. So let's go meet Nyerere and Nyerere real quick and see what they're getting into. And here is Nyerere and Nyerere.
Say hi.
Say good morning.
Say good morning.
Good morning. Nyerere and Nyerere.
Naima, we wish you luck as you make a journey cross country, and we wish you all the best when you get to California. We can't wait to come out and visit you, all three of us, including this one.
I appreciate that. I don't know, Martina, do you mind if I shoot you real quick? You seem like you're dressed. Just a real quick hello. It's kind of dark. That's okay, we can't really see. Just say hi. It's too dark in here anyway, but just say hi. That's Martina, my cousin. That's Nyerere's husband and Nyerere's mommy. So that's it. That's all from Statham. I am headed to Bay St. Louis, Mississippi now today, taking about a 7-hour drive. And that should be pretty interesting. I'll show you the house that my family has owned for years that was completely gutted and decimated in Katrina, and that they've now, my mother almost has fully restored. So that'll be the next stop. See you a little bit down the road.